Assalamu alaikum. Control systems are very important and they find their applications in many modern industrial processes. To control some process, we need to know its behavior, and behavior of a process can be described by a mathematical model. In the last lecture, we revisited our understanding about mathematical modeling of electrical systems and mathematical modeling of electronic systems. And in today's lecture, we shall talk about mathematical modeling of mechanical systems. Basically, there are two types of displacements in mechanical systems, that is the translational displacement and rotational displacement. And in today's lecture, we shall discuss mathematical modeling of mechanical systems with translational displacement. Like in electrical circuits, where there are three basic components, that is resistor, capacitor and inductor, in mechanical systems there are also three basic components, that is spring, mass and viscous friction. And the strategy to obtain mathematical model for mechanical systems with translational displacement is to write force balance equations. That is, the sum of forces acting on an object towards left is equal to sum of forces acting on an object towards right. Before we proceed for mathematical modeling of some mechanical system, let's first briefly talk about the three basic components. So the first basic component in mechanical systems with translational displacement is a translational spring, which is shown by this symbol. Here one end of this spring is fixed and cannot move. The other end has a displacement x of t when a force f of t is applied on it. And by the Hooke's law, the displacement produced in the spring x of t is proportional to the applied force. The proportionality constant k is called the spring constant. It is the intrinsic property of the spring. The same expression which is written over here can be rewritten like this one. Here v is the velocity, and we know that integral of velocity is the displacement. Thus force f of t is equal to spring constant k multiplied by integral of velocity from time 0 to time t. The second basic component in mechanical systems is a viscous damper, which is shown by this symbol. One end of this damper is fixed and the other end has displacement x of t when force f of t is applied on it. The damper coefficient is denoted by fv, and again it is property of the damper itself. In a viscous damper, the velocity is proportional to the applied force, that is f of t is equal to spring damper coefficient fv multiplied by the velocity v of t. The same expression can be rewritten like this one. The derivative of displacement multiplied by the damper coefficient is equal to the applied force. The third basic component in mechanical systems is mass, and we assume that this is a rigid mass. That is, when we apply a force on this mass, there is no elongation in the this object. That is, both this end of the object and this end of the object, both of them have the same displacement x of t. We know that when we apply a force on an object, it produces an acceleration in it, and for mass m, this acceleration is proportional to the applied force. That is, derivative of velocity, which is acceleration, multiplied by mass is equal to the force, applied force. The same equation can be rewritten like this one. The second derivative of displacement, which is basically the same as acceleration multiplied by mass of the object, that is equal to the applied force. Let's now take a simple mechanical system and obtain its mathematical model. This simple mechanical system is shown by this figure, which consists of a mass, a spring and a damper. One end of both the spring and the damper, these are fixed and cannot move. The other ends are connected to this mass, and on this mass we have applied an external force f of t, which produces a translational displacement x of t. The easiest approach to obtain mathematical model of mechanical systems is to draw a free body diagram. A free body diagram is basically a diagram which shows all the forces acting on an object. The free body diagram for this mechanical system is shown by this figure. Here, x of t is the linear displacement of this object, f of t is the externally applied force, and we can see that when this object is moving towards right, this spring will apply a force towards left, and the magnitude of the force applied by the spring is proportional to the displacement x. That is, the force applied by the spring is towards left and its magnitude is the spring constant k multiplied by the displacement x of t. Likewise, the force applied by the damper is also towards left and its magnitude is proportional to the velocity of this end. Thus, the force applied by the damper is shown over here, and its magnitude is fv multiplied by dx by dt. The third force that is acting on this object is due to inertia, and its magnitude is proportional to the acceleration. That is, this force is given by m multiplied by second derivative of the displacement. The direction of this force is always opposite to the direction of acceleration. Now, the mathematical model can be obtained by writing the force balance equation. That is, the sum of forces acting towards left is equal to the sum of forces acting towards right. That is, m d square x by dt square plus fv dx by dt plus kx, that is equal to f of t. This first term is the force due to inertia of the object. The second term is the force due to the viscous damper, and the third this term is the force due to the spring. Sum of all these forces is equal to the force which is acting towards right. We can take the Laplace transform of this equation, which is shown by this equation. Here we have taken all initial conditions to be equal to zero. We already know that the Laplace transform of a derivative of a variable is equal to Laplace transform of that variable multiplied by s. Now, if we are interested in a transfer function for the system with the displacement x of t as output and the force as an input, we can rewrite this equation by taking x of s common from the left hand side, and this equation can be further rewritten in this form. That is, x of s over f of s is equal to 1 over m s square plus f v s plus k, which describes the transfer function of this mechanical system. In the previous slide, we obtained a free body diagram in time domain, and then a differential equation was obtained which described the mathematical model. Then we obtain the Laplace transform of that differential equation to finally obtain the transfer function. Some intermediate steps can be avoided if we directly sketch the free body diagram in S domain, Laplace domain, the free body diagram in Laplace domain is shown over here. All the variables are written in Laplace domain. Here, this is the force due to damper, and we remember that that force was proportional to derivative of the translational displacement, and we know that derivative of a variable written in Laplace domain is equal to the Laplace transform of that variable multiplied by s. Likewise, second derivative is replaced by the Laplace transform of that variable multiplied by s square. And then we have the same equation by writing the force balance equation, from where we can obtain the transfer function for that particular system. Electrical circuits and mechanical systems, they have many similarities. For example, the three basic components in electrical circuits are capacitor, resistor, and inductor, which are the working of these components is governed by these three equations. Likewise, in mechanical systems, we have three basic components: spring, viscous damper, and mass, and the working of these components is governed by these three different three equations. We can see the similarity between the equations for mechanical components and equations for electrical components. We can see that a capacitor equation governing the capacitor is similar to the equation governing the spring. That is, a constant multiplied by integral of velocity, here a constant multiplied by integral of this capacitor. Here there is a typo, it should be t, it is not 1 over here. Likewise, a resistor, the equation governing the resistor is similar to the equation which governs the damper. Equation for this mass is similar to equation for an inductor. Furthermore, force in mechanical systems is analogous to voltage in electrical circuits, and velocity in mechanical systems is analogous to current in electrical circuits. You remember that in electrical circuits, defined impedance is defined as ratio, Laplace transform of is defined as ratio of voltage and current. So similarly, if we define mechanical impedance, it can be defined by force divided by velocity, because force is analogous to voltage and velocity in mechanical circuits is analogous to current. Here remember that this V is for velocity and here this V is for voltage, so do not confuse the two. So if we define mechanical impedance, that should be like this. However, in mechanical systems, we are more interested in displacement than in the velocity. So we misdefine mechanical impedance as force divided by the displacement. And in the next part of this lecture, we shall talk about another mechanical system, which will be little bit complex, and then we shall also study how we can use this mechanical impedance concept of mechanical impedance in obtaining mathematical model for mechanical system.